Have you ever tried to create a multicam video and it ended up in a chaotic mess? Then you're not alone. See, syncing clips, matching audio, switching angles, it can get overwhelming fast. But what if I told you there's a tool that can make all of that way easier? Let's talk about it. See, DaVinci Resolve 20 is here to change the game. This software lets you create stunning multicam videos without the stress thanks to its AI advanced features. You can now automatically sync clips, detect scenes, and even make smart cuts with just a few clicks. It's like having a pro video editor built right into your workflow. As a part of the Blackmagic Design family, DaVinci Resolve has come a long way. It started as a color grading tool, but now it's a full-fledged editing powerhouse used by pros and hobbyists alike. And with DaVinci Resolve 20, they've seriously raised the bar. Blackmagic is always pushing the boundaries, and this version is packed with powerful, easy-to-use features. So what makes Resolve 20 really special? Let's break it down. First, it's AI-powered multicam sync. It can automatically sync all your camera angles using audio or timecode. Then, there's the scene detection. This analyzes your footage and breaks it into clean, logical cuts, saving you tons of time. And then there's the smart cut. It scans your clips and finds precise edit points, cutting out dead space and awkward pauses. These tools just don't save you time. They unlock your creativity so you can focus on the story while Resolve handles the technical heavy lifting. However, I must say, it's not perfect. The AI features can be a little finicky sometimes, and you may need to tweak a few manual things. But in my experience, the pros far outweigh the cons. Compared to other editing software like Premiere Pro or Final Cut, DaVinci Resolve is holding its own. And I recently worked on a podcast where I had to use multiple cameras, and normally syncing everything would take me hours. But with DaVinci Resolve 20, I synced everything in minutes. The results? A smooth, professional multicam video that the client absolutely loves. Now, let me show you how it works. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve 20, and right now I am on the edit page. And as you can see, I have three clips here from my project. And what I'm gonna do is that I'm going to highlight these. This is my camera one, my middle camera, and my third angle. And what I'm gonna do is click on all three of those while they're selected. And I'm gonna go down in this menu and create new multicam clip using the selected clips. And immediately once you do that, then you have this window that pops up. And these are the parameters that you are going to change to create your multicam clip. For this tutorial, I'm just gonna name this multicam sync. And it's also with the time code, you're gonna leave that starting where it's at, frame rate 24. And here it's asking you, how do you want to sync this multicam? For most multicam sync, you can do timecode. If you've used timecode, you can go ahead and do that. So then you would click on timecode. For this tutorial, I am going to click on sound because that's how I want to bring all these clips together for the multicam clip. Here also, for the multicam audio, we're just gonna leave that. And clip name, I want to leave those as the names that I've given the clips. I don't want to change them, so I'm going to use clip names. And those are the parameters that I use to create my multicam clip. So once you've done that, then what you're gonna do is click on create. Then Resolve is going to go through and it's going to create that multicam clip for you. And as you can see, Resolve is going to go through, analyze the clips, and it is going to create that multicam clip for you. Okay, so now that Resolve has gone and created our multicam clip, what we're gonna do is take it and just drag it onto our timeline. And once it's on our timeline, we're gonna give it a click, and immediately our multicam viewer pops up. But I also like to open another window so I can see the final and I can see my multicam clips at the same time. So in my experience with this, what I've noticed is that when I go through and I click on my multicam viewer, immediately I see my smart multicam sync pops up right here. I've also noticed that sometimes it doesn't actually pop up. So if you get this little smart icon that pops up here, what you want to do is go ahead and click on it, and immediately this window pops up. But for whatever reason, let's just say you don't see this multicam icon here. What you can also do is right click on your multicam clip on the timeline, and you can go right down here where it says multicam smart switch, and you can click on it on this, and the same window is going to pop up. So I have just left the default settings that Resolve 20 suggested, and I've left those. I've said, you know, automatically detect wide angles. And if you don't want to do that, you can uncheck it and say use your wide angle as your third angle. But I don't want to do that. What I want to do is leave that checked so that Resolve can use my middle camera as a camera where it uses for the silence or awkward pauses. So I'm just going to leave that the way it is. And once you have left the defaults, what you're going to do is just click on analyze, and it's going to go through and it's going to really, really quickly just analyze the timeline, and it's going to go through and make smart cuts on your edit. So this is what Resolve 20 did. The multicam sync went through and it found the points where it wanted to cut based on the parameters that was set. And I think it did a really, really good job. So here I have the two windows open, and you're gonna see where it's switching the angles. And on the left, you can see all the angles, and on the right, you're gonna see the final. So I'm just gonna play that back for you, and you can see what the multicam sync did.
All right, so Jermaine, that was Cinderella,
sir,
which is one of my standout tracks in terms of your reinvention in terms of the sound.
Yeah.
But definitely fusing the reggae vocal styles to make it Jermaine Cowan. So that brings us to one you did do, probably the biggest music video, I think, out of the project so far.
Yeah.
It's Guyello.
Jeez.
Let's hear just a little piece of it.
Yeah.
Man, that is really, really, really good. Also, I want you to keep in mind that you can always go back and tweak these angles if you don't like the cuts. You can always make little tweaks. But this AI sync is to kind of get you to the point where you don't have to literally sit there for hours and manually cut through every single part of the edit. It can bring you really, really close. So let's just say it made a cut in this angle and it put the middle camera there and you didn't want it there. Or maybe you're saying, you know what, it's too long, I want to create another angle. You can click on any one of these clips, any single one of them. You can take your pointer here and you can drag and move that over wherever, to whatever point you want to do that. And let's just say that you found this clip to be long. Now you can click on it, you can make a cut, and then you can right click on it and go to switch multicam clip angle. And then you can choose whatever angle you want to put on here. And let's just say I wanted that clip to be my Jermaine 2 over here that I called it. You can go and change that to whatever you want to, and immediately it switches to that angle. Let's just go back here and switch to another angle, right? It immediately goes back. And let's just say you did all that switching and you're like, ah, man, I really like the middle camera there. Let's just go back and put the middle camera. So you can go back in and tweak as much as you want and make the multicam sync exactly how you want it. But this software and the Multicam Sync brings you to a point where you don't have to do a lot of the heavy lifting.
I don't know about you, but I am very impressed with this feature, and I'd give it a solid 9 out of 10. This AI Multicam feature is a game changer, and its overall performance is actually amazing. If you're interested in learning more, please check out my other videos on the new features in DaVinci Resolve 20. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell for more content. Thanks for watching, and remember, keep creating, keep pushing, and I'll see you in the next one.